Welcome viewers. In this video, I am going to demonstrate about cut section of testis along with its coverings, that is the fascias, scrotal sac and skin. First, let me briefly explain you about the testis. The testis, also called testicles, are two oval-shaped organs in the male reproductive system. They are contained in a sac of skin called the scrotum. The testis also produce a hormone called testosterone. This hormone is responsible for sex drive, fertility, and the development of muscle and bone mass. Now you are able to see the tunica vaginalis parietal, and inner to it there is tunica vaginalis visceral. These both are parts of tunica vaginalis. Tunica vaginalis represents lower persistent portion of processus vaginalis. Now you are able to see ductus deferens. The ductus deferens is about 45 cm long when it is straightened. The ductus deferens is a thick-walled muscular tube which transmits spermatozoa from the epididymis to ejaculatory duct. Now you can see the pampiniform plexus. The pampiniform plexus is a loose network of small veins found within the male spermatic cord. The veins of the plexus ascend along the spermatic cord at the front of the ductus deferens. The pampiniform plexus helps regulate the temperature of the testis by acting as a heat exchange mechanism to cool down the blood. Now next is the ductus epididymis, which is a comma-shaped organ. It is tightly coiled structure with a total length of 6 cm. Epididymis is divided into three parts: head, body and tail. The body is a narrow and middle portion of the epididymis, whereas the tail is the lower, smaller portion of epididymis. Ductus epididymis continues to ductus deferens. Now you are able to see the efferent ductules, which are a series of parallel, thin, delicate tubules that connect the rete testis to a single tube, the epididymis. The efferent ducts are often referred to as conduits because sperm travels so rapidly through these tubules into the epididymis. Now you can see the testicular vein and the testicular artery. The testicular vein, otherwise also called spermatic vein, is the male gonadal vein, which carries deoxygenated blood from its corresponding testis to the inferior vena cava or one of its tributaries. The testicular artery, that is the male gonadal artery, also called the internal spermatic artery, is a branch of the abdominal aorta that supplies blood to the testis. It is a paired artery with one for each of the testis. Now next is the tunica albuginea. The tunica albuginea is the fibrous tissue covering of the testis. It is a dense blue-gray membrane composed of bundles of white fibrous connective tissue from which it derives its name, albuginea. Now you are able to see testicular lobules, which is the granular part consisting of 200 to 300 lobules. Each testicular lobule contains 2 to 3 seminiferous tubules. Seminiferous tubules join together at apices of lobules to form 20 to 30 straight tubules, and these ultimately anastomosis with each other to form rete testis. Rete testis give rise to 12 to 30 efferent ducts which enter the epididymis. Now you are able to see the fascia of testis. The internal spermatic fascia is derived from the transversalis fascia. It is acquired by the spermatic cord at the deep inguinal ring. The cremastric fascia is the fascia in the scrotum. As the cremaster descends, it forms a series of loops which differ in thickness and length in different subjects. At the upper part of the cord, the loops are short, but they become in succession longer and longer, the longest reaching down as low as the testis, where a few are inserted into the tunica vaginalis. These loops are united together by annular tissue and form a thin covering over the testis. The external spermatic fascia, also called intercrural or intercolumnar fascia, is a thin membrane prolonged downward around the surface of spermatic cord and testis. It is separated from the dartos tunic by loose annular tissue. The dartos fascia, or simply dartos, is a layer of connective tissue found in the penile shaft, foreskin and scrotum. The penile portion is referred to as the superficial fascia of penis or the subcutaneous tissue of penis, while the scrotal part is the dartos proper. In addition to being continuous with itself, the scrotum and the penis, it is also continuous with colles fascia of the perineum and scarpas fascia of the abdomen. The scrotum is a sac of skin that hangs from the body at the front of the pelvis between the legs. It sits next to the upper thighs, just below the penis. Hope you find this video useful for additional information about the testes.